Rookies and veterans making a big move going into day two at TPC Scottsdale.
Welcome to the latest edition of PGA Tour Today.
Clear skies, light winds, setting the stage for some low scores at the 2010 Waste Management Phoenix Open. Hello everyone, I'm Casey Black. Camila Vajegas is on fire in the desert going into Friday with a career-low, flawless opening round 62. Take a look at this scorecard. Vajegas averaged 307 yards per drive, hit 14 out of 18 greens in regulation, and once it got there, he had 25 total putts in his round. Just last week, he finished third at the Accenture Match Play Championship, where he missed a short putt that would have moved him into the championship match with Ian Poulter. For Vajegas, 2008 was a breakthrough year with back-to-back victories during the FedEx Cup playoffs and a seventh-place world ranking. In 2009, Vajegas dropped to 24th in the world. He'll be teeing off Friday at 12:44 with Jeff Ogilvie and Brian Gay. Rookies Matt Every and Ricky Fowler are in striking position moving into the second round. Every, who sits one shot behind Vajegas, started off Thursday with four straight birdies in a row. One to watch, Every's first career professional win came at the Nationwide Tour Championship. Fellow rookie Ricky Fowler is a hard one to miss. The young phenom shot an opening round 6 under 65. He'll tee off at 120 on Friday. From the rookies to veteran Fred Couples. He hasn't had a lot of luck at TPC Scottsdale. In his last four attempts, he's missed the cut, but perhaps this year will be different.
On the PGA Tour, I just feel like maybe I get a little nervous or edgy because I still want to shoot scores like I did today. I mean, on the afternoon, I'm going to have one of the better scores, and I'm capable of doing that.
Couples, who shot a 4 under 67, turned 50 last October. He's playing his second event on the PGA Tour this year and has already claimed victory on the Champions Tour this year at the Ace Group Classic. Phil Mickelson is in familiar territory at an event he has seen to dominate in the past. The Arizona State alum is 3 under heading into Friday. Mickelson has won this event twice in 1996 and 2005, has had 9 top 10 finishes and shot the course record in 05. He certainly is a crowd favorite, especially around the par 3 16th Kodak Challenge hole, where thousands of screaming fans greet him. He'll be teeing off Friday at 8:04 with Ryan Palmer and Ian Poulter, who had a breakthrough win last week at the Accenture Match Play Championship. If Poulter can pull off another win, he'll be the first person to win in Tucson and Phoenix in the same year since Mickelson in 1996. Fred Albers from the PGA Tour Network, Sirius XM Radio, has more from Phoenix.
The 2010 Waste Management Phoenix Open is all about recycling. This is a recycle reward machine. You put the used cans in here, and then you get a voucher that can be used anywhere on the golf course. I'll tell you who did not waste many shots in the opening round. Camila Vajegas chipped in for birdie on his final hole, shoots 9 under par. But things change for the second round. Camila played in perfect weather in that opening round where the wind came up in the afternoon. Those tee times will be flipped for Friday in the second round. Camila Vajegas will go late, could have some wind to deal with, and a player like Phil Mickelson, who went late in the opening round, will have good greens to putt on the entire day as he goes early on Friday. You can catch all the action on the PGA Tour Network. Our coverage begins at 2 o'clock Eastern Time, and of course, check back to PGAtour.com throughout the day for your latest updates.
Second round coverage of the Waste Management Phoenix Open can be heard on the PGA Tour Network, Sirius 209 and XM 146, and PGAtour.com beginning at 2 p.m. Eastern Time. And coverage on the Golf Channel starts at 4 p.m. Eastern Time. For instant golf coverage anytime, check out PGAtour.com.